off Bimini Island, sharks appear to be targeting dolphins as prey. Dr. Mike Heithouse wants to film these predations by attaching a camera to the fin of a great hammerhead. His first attempt ended in failure, but he's back to try again.
Bug's worked out, cameras are ready to go, hammerheads are here. I'm feeling pretty good. Got it! But we need to get the VHF gear out and start waiting to hear if it pops off. I am very happy, but I'll be much happier when that camera is back in our hands. Because until we get the camera back, we have no data.
Now they hope the camera's release mechanism works and they can retrieve it. It's like finding a needle in a haystack, only this needle is moving.
Fire it up here. Okay, it's up. Now we just basically have to wing. We'll hear the pinging sound and then we can go pick it up and see what that shark's been up to.
But if it goes after a dolphin, it might not come out on top. Evolution has given dolphins a few skills. Some seem like superpowers. Scientists at the Dolphin Research Center in Florida test the special abilities of dolphins. Emily Garino trains Jack's.
So up here is a dolphin's dorsal fin. Jax's is going to look a little different than other dolphins. When he was a baby, estimated about 8 months old, he was found orphaned and injured in the Jacksonville River. He had been attacked by sharks.
It does seem like sharks get the upper hand when they run into dolphins. But not always. Dolphins have a special weapon, a sixth sense called echolocation.
So up here, this is Jax's melon. This is where when he echolocates, and this is a simulation of echolocation, what it sounds like. But that comes from up here, and he receives those signals back in his lower jaw here.
Dolphins emit sound waves like a sonar. The waves bounce back with information about what they hit. The information is decoded by the dolphin's brain, giving it a picture of what's ahead. They use it to navigate, communicate, and even stun and kill prey, and evade sharks. Dolphins Jax and Tanner play a game to show how it works. Can Tanner imitate what Jax is doing if he can't see him do it?
The question is, how are they imitating blindfolded? And there are two ways they could do it. One of them is they could recognize the characteristic sound of the behavior, or they could be echolocating on the behavior. That's their biological sonar to sort of see with sound. And what we found out is they actually use both in a problem-solving kind of way.
Tanner's eyes are covered, but he still knows exactly what Jax is doing every time. Echolocation can mean the difference between seeing an ambush coming and maybe turning the tables on a shark. That's what happened off the coast of Western Australia. A dolphin burst to the surface, ramming a milk shark with its snout. The shark is tossed like a rag doll and carried away to be eaten. This time, it's the shark that's on the menu. Unfortunately, sharks may have figured out a weak spot in the echolocation defense.
Echolocation's great for finding your way around darker turbid waters, but it's not the be-all end-all. It's kind of limited to a narrow beam out front, so there are these big blind spots that a shark can use to sneak up on a dolphin.
Even so, echolocation does help dolphins survive in the ocean. But sharks have evolved a super sense too. It's called electroreception. It lets sharks detect the electrical fields emitted by all living creatures, allowing them to hunt in the dark. Small black pores along their snout open into ampullae of Lorenzini, passages filled with conductive jelly and tiny hair-like cells called cilia. They can detect the faintest electrical charges emitted by fish and dolphins. Super sensitive, sharks can detect a current as weak as 1/1,000,000,000th of a volt. Sharks have electroreceptivity, and dolphins have echolocation. Who has the edge? Maybe it's a draw. But dolphins are mammals like us, so they have another weapon, their intelligence. Research shows that the dolphin brain is second only to humans among mammals. Can they outsmart the sharks?